Thank you, Tiago. You representative, Mr. Tiago Guerrero, project leader, IPKC, your businesses, colleagues and friends. Very good afternoon. At the outset, on behalf of the Intellectual Property Office of Vietnam, I would like to thank the IPKC project for the initiative to organize the IPKC EU Business Forum today. As you are aware, the EU is now one of Vietnam's major trading partners, with two-way trade turnover in 2019 reaching $57 billion, of which exports amounted to $42 billion, and imports from EU were $15 billion. Besides, the EU has been an active foreign direct investor in Vietnam, and FDI in Vietnam amounted to $38 billion in 2019. As you all know, the European Union-Vietnam Free Trade Agreement took effect on the 1st of August 2020. EVFTA is a comprehensive, high-quality agreement with high and broad commitment, including both traditional and non-traditional sectors such as government procurement, intellectual property and sustainable development, etc. It is strongly convinced that EVFTA will pave the way for increased trade and investment between EU and Vietnam. Therefore, the IPKC EU Business Forum today is a good opportunity for us to promote and showcase the initiatives in enhancing IPR protection and enforcement in the country, as well as discussing issues of concern of both sides in the field. We look forward for a fruitful discussion ahead. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Deputy Director General Dr. Tan Le Hong, for those opening remarks. For the introduction to the future of IP governance in Vietnam, and to provide us with a more in-depth perspective of the various programs and initiatives of IP Vietnam, our next speaker obtained her bachelor's degree on international relations and her master's degree on international law from the Diplomatic Academy of Vietnam. She is currently responsible for handling international IP legal issues with multilateral frameworks, including the negotiation of IP-related international treaties and agreements. May I welcome Ms. Dorothy Han, Deputy Director of Legislation and Policy Division of IP Vietnam, to discuss with us the future amendments to the IP legal framework of Vietnam and initiatives for enhancing the quality of services of the IP Office of Vietnam.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to briefly introduce some plans for future amendments of the National IP Legal Framework and the initiatives for enhancing the quality service of the IP Office of Vietnam. Firstly, I would like to introduce about the plan for the future amendment of the National IP Legal Framework. As I think you already know about the meaning of the IP law, so let me skip the saying about the meaning of the IP law and go directly to the objective of the amendment of the IP law. Actually, the amendment to the National IP Legal Framework objectives is to meet the demands after 10 years of implementation of the current IP law and other guiding documents to overcome the shortcomings of those. And the second one is to institutionalize and incorporate international commitment to create legal frameworks or IP activities in Vietnam. And the third one is ensure the stability, unity, complexity, transparency, feasibility, and accessibility, and the effectiveness and efficiencies of the IP legal system with a view to contribute to the national development. And now I would like to talk about the law that amend and supplementing a number of articles of the IP law. First about the, next one please. First about the roadmap. Yeah, according to the roadmap, the draft of the law is open for a comment from the public in November 2020, and it is expected to be submitted to the government for considerations in April 2021. And it will be submit to the National Assembly for considering in December 2021. And in 2022, we will submit it to the National Assembly for approval. And we expect the law to come into effect in July 2022. You may have questions about the commitment under EVFTA, but where it's because it's now come into effect. Yeah, for those commitments that are not compatible with our IP law and our other documents, we implement them directly under the EVFTA, and we provide for it in the resolutions number 102 by the National Assembly, which ratifying the EVFTA. Now I come to the six groups of policies that will be introduced in the law amending a number of articles of the IP law. The first one is to encouraging the creation and exploitation and dissemination of invention, industrial design and layout created or arised from the researchers that are funded by the state. And the second one is facilitating the procedures for establishment of industrial property rights. The third one is ensuring adequate and balanced level of IP protection. The fourth one is improving the effectiveness of IP support activity. The fifth one is improving the efficiencies of IPR enforcement activity. And the last one is ensuring the implementation of Vietnam international commitment on IP protection. About the first group of policies, which in our objectives is overcome the shortcoming relating the protection and exploitation of IPR to the inventions, industrial designs, and layout arising from the state fund researches. We intend to amend the IP law to allow the organization that conduct the state fund researches to acquire ownership of IP rights to invention, industrial designs, and layout design made under the state fund researches with several conditions and limitations and obligations. The second group regarding the facilitating the establishment procedures of industrial property rights, we have some the objectives is addressing the inadequacies of the current legislation on the established procedures of industrial property rights. For example, the first one is third-party opinion. Second one is security control to patent applications. The third one is the document in industrial design application and appeal procedures. The detailed contents of those policies is, for example, from the first one, third-party opinion. Now we have one framework for both third-party opposition and third-party observation. So in the future, we intend to divide in two groups, two frames. One is the third-party oppositions. We will fix the time to 3 to 9 months. And for third-party observation, the time to send the observation is the from the publication of the application to the before to the time before we issue the grant, and the information is filed under the framework. Third party observation is considered as information for reference of the examiners. Regarding the document that identifying the designs, we simplify the requirement for that document. We don't require pointing out the only prior designs, and that's, we may require only pointing out the main features of the designs. And for security control to patent applications, actually, now it is provided for under the degree 103 with the scope very broad. And that's caused some obstacles or some difficulties for implementation, or only raised concerns from the businesses. So we intend to provide in the law and limit the subject that must have to go through the procedures. For the third, for the last one, the appeal procedures, we provide for some typical elements for industrial procedures. For example, the time limit for appeal settlements, the fee, and also the way to file the appeal application. That is all in group two. And now about group three is ensuring adequate and balanced level of protection. Our objective is to do it by through clarifying or supplementing some provision in the current legal system. First one, for patents, we broaden the prior art, which is used to evaluate the novelty of the inventions. That means we will use the invention that is disclosed in the patent application with earlier filing date or priority date, but not yet public, to evaluate the novelties of the invention that is in the later application. Of course, with the condition that the prior application is a public after that. And for we also intend to supplement grounds for cancellation of patents. For example, We based on the fact that the invention is not sufficiently disclosed for the people of ordinary skill in the art and carry out. So in that case, the patents will be canceled, or the claims. In fact, the claim is broader than the disclosure. And we also intend to supplement the ground for granting compulsory license in accordance with the Article 21 bis of the TRIPS Agreement. That's for patent. And for trademark, we supplement some provision dealing with the conflict between the name of plant variety and trademark. So we intend to provide the size that is used to register as the trademark will be refused if it is the name of the variety. Of course, it is when it is registered for the good, that is the tree or the products that we gain from the trees, the plant variety. And we intend also abolish the provision and associated mark. We also provide for the trademarks registered with bad faith. That is an issue is interested by many investors, including one from those from EU, I think. And we also provide more grounds for cancellations of trademark registration. For example, when the use of a trademark is by the owner or with his consent mislead the public as to the nature or qualities of the goods, or it's become the common name of a product or service, it is registered. Those we commit under the EVFTA. And for GI, we clarify the abilities of the protection for homonymous GI, because it will follow the principle in the TRIPS agreement and also the commitment under EVFTA. That means when homonymous GI is protected, it must be used in the way that do not mislead the consumer. The group number four is improving the effectiveness of IP supportive activities. Actually, in this, our provision regarding the IP supporting activities has some shortcomings, and we intend to overcome those. And we intend to divide the IP representatives to two groups. The first one is patent representative, and the second one is a trademark representative. And we simplify some requirements or provide for some exception for trademark representative. For example, now it under our current laws, if you want to practice at trademark representative before the IP office, you have to pass to the exam. But we intended to actually allow the lawyer do not have to pass the exams. It means that lawyer can practice at trademark representatives before IP office without any participation or passing the exam that's organized by the IP office. For the condition for practicing a IP assessment, we intend to replace the conditions to pass the professional exam with the condition as finishing the training course assessment, or we may provide for some more exceptions that can practice at IP assessment before the office if they meet some conditions regarding experience, etc. The group number five, regarding the improving the efficiencies of IPR enforcement activities. For this one, we intend to amend some of the provision regarding administrative enforcement measure and border measures. The first one for administrative enforcement methods, because in our current law, it is too broad and that we don't have enough resources to maintain so large scope. So in the future, we tend to apply these measures to only infringing acts to relating to counterfeit trademark goods, counterfeit GI goods, and infringing copyright goods. For border measures, in the future, we intend to apply for those three that I have mentioned, that is for trademarks, GI, and copyrights. For the last one, the sixth group, implementation of Vietnam international commitment. Actually, this one is fixed to implement the commitment under the CPTPP and EVFTA. So we have several policies at below. First one is for trademark, we allow the registration of sound mark, and we supplement some grounds for termination of trademark registration, as I already mentioned in the third group. And for industrial design, we refine the condition for the protection of a design of a component part in a complex product. And for border measure, border enforcement, we will allow ex officio action by the custom authority to suspend the release of the suspected trademark counterfeit goods and pirated copyright goods. For patent, we provide for mechanism to compensate for the patent right holder if there is a delay in the market approval process. The method for compensation is now under discussion, but you can see one of the method for compensation is introduced in the resolution 102 issued by the National Assembly. For undisclosed information, in the amendment law, we will introduce the test data exclusivity mechanism for the data of used for the marketing approval for process of agrochemical production products within 10 years. And we also provide the obligation to public the marketing authorization application within a period of 5 months if the the later applicant rely on a permitted pharmaceutical product in his application so that the patent right holder can have time to seek for enforcement measures. So that's all about the intention to for amending our law, IP law. And of course, following the IP law, we will issue the documents that providing guidance for the IP law, and they are expected to have to come into effect in 2023. Yeah, the second part of my presentation is about the improvement of the quality of the IP office of Vietnam. Yeah, actually, as we can consider that IP is very important to the economic development, so in 2019, the Vietnam government issued the National Intellectual Property Strategy to 2030. So one of the solutions that that is set out is to improve the effectiveness and efficiencies of the state management of intellectual property. And in 2020, the Ministry of Science and Technology issues the organization that the IP office belong to, issued the plan for implementation of that strategy. So the main task that we identify in that strategy is promoting the application of information technology on handling administrative procedures as monitoring and processing the application of industrial property and providing online public services. And the second one is amending the examination manual for industrial property applications. So for patent, trademark, GI, we intend to do it in 2021. For design, in 2023, and we also intend to revise other manual regarding related procedures also. The third task that we identify is developing the projects of consolidating the organization structures and operation of the IP office, and of course that's when including preparation of the resource for operation. The fourth task is about upgrading the system of IP database to serve activity of researchers and development, establishment, exploitation, and protection of IP rights. So based on that identified task, we are now doing, first we are providing online public service on the roadmap. Actually in August, we has launched first online services for trademark filing the trademark applications and other relating to maintenance of the registrations. And we intended to do more in this year. I think it's at the end of this year, we will have 16 more. That allowed the applicant to do full own online. And the second one that we are doing is developing the project of consolidating the organization structures and operations. Next one is we already established one top division that's dealing with all the issues like receiving the applications and giving out the grant, this certificate. And the fourth one is that we are doing is supervising the implementation of all administrative procedures, and we're reviewing them on periodically. Actually, we make the report every three months, and based on that report, we will propose the way to simplify the procedures. So that's all what we're doing to improve the quality of the IP office service. Thank you for your attentions.
Good afternoon, everybody. It's my pleasure to introduce you some information about IP training and public awareness improvement activity provided by IP Vietnam. Next slide, please. My presentation will focus on the IP consultation and training activities, the challenges we face, and the opportunities we can get to improve quality of training and consultation activities. As an IP office, IP Vietnam, the traditional function of IP Vietnam are receiving IPR's registration application and granting the rights, including domestic application and the application filed under the three international registration system. IP training activity are also focused on IP Vietnam internal training and training for other subjects in the IP system. The support activity in recent year have been extended and in diversified forms. Since 2006, the National Program on IP Asset Development was approved and implemented. Up to now, it has run three periods for 15 years, and the IP Vietnam plays the role of the program management agency. Now, IP Vietnam are building the plan for the next 10 years. These three supporting activities for the development of IP system have been enhanced in recent years and also got some remarkable achievements, contributing to the increasing numbers of IPR application and grants in Vietnam. This three supporting is IP training, IP consultation, and some supporting program. Next slide, please. In our supporting activities, SMEs are the important beneficiary of IP training and supporting activity. So we recognize that the IP training and supporting for SMEs are very necessary and will be implemented by IP Vietnam in the coming time. According to the statistics on IPR's registration, it shows that in Vietnam, SMEs do not have many valuable IP assets, partly because they do not know how to use IP as an effective tool to improve their competitiveness. Most SMEs in Vietnam do not master technology, and they do not consider IP strategy as a priority in the business strategy. Next slide, please. And as I mentioned before, National Program of IP Asset Development run from 2006. There are some main activities conducted by this program. The first is to raise the awareness of organization and individuals on IP. And the second activity is provide professional training on IP for some subject. And the third is to support the exploitation and commercialization of invention utility solution in Vietnam. And the fourth is support the protection management and development of IPRs for specific local products. And the fifth is to support building and implementing the model of management and development of IP asset in some SMEs or some science and technology organizer. The sixth is to support the registration of IPR protection in country and abroad for national product. And these are some remarkable results that we get in these two periods, about for 10 years. Approximately 5,000 programs broadcast on TV is very diversified and and tens of thousands of pupils are trained on IP. And we directly support science and technology organization and enterprise on IPR's protection, management, and enforcement, and some other achievement you can see on the slide. In addition, the other activities also to carry out annual something like training course and dissemination programs. In 2019, nearly 60 training course and seminar with more than 5,000 participants were organized. And we also organized some IP competition and some IP materials were draft and print and upload on IP Vietnam's website and other consultation activities through hotline or exhibitions. In order to satisfy the societal needs on IP training, IP Vietnam designed and opened some different training courses. We have a professional course, shortened course, and basic course, and distance learning. And some distance learning course we are under construction. And this picture you can see some activities of our office, some competitions, IP competition for students, programs on TV, or activity to celebrate IP days are carried out every year, or some activity to support the local products developed based on IP. One of the newly established frameworks that paved the way for expanding the IP support and training activities is the IP strategy by 2030 that issued last year, as my colleague mentioned as the previous presentation. And this strategy identifies the objective, task, and solution to develop IP system in Vietnam. In this strategy, IP training should be paid attention for building an IP culture in the society. Through the first year, we also conduct some activity like propagating and disseminating the strategies, contents, and the implementation plans. And IP Vietnam also support the local to develop implementation plans in accordance with their situation. And we also conduct some IP training, public awareness, and consultation activities. In practice of training and consultation activity in this year, we also see new challenges and opportunities, and some outstanding challenges found that the development of technology and IP system is very fast. So the demand for IP training and consultation is increasing in quantity and diversifying. But we lack a resort. We lack expert trainers, materials, and the lack of IP awareness of society, especially in SMEs. Besides the challenge, we also can see some opportunity that we can take advantage. Those the first is concern of the government, that is the IP strategy by 2030 issued. And the second opportunity we found that is international cooperation. We have a lot of opportunities for learning and sharing experience on IP teaching. And the third is SMEs have many channels to access IP knowledge. And the public awareness about IP is improving step by step. Based on the challenge and opportunity, we also identified some plans in the coming time for IP training and supporting activities. We plan to expand the content scope of training, disseminations, and consultation activities, especially focus on new issues to meet the needs of society, disseminate the knowledge about newly acquired international treaties, New Generation FTIs, like the Hague Agreement, EVFTI, CPTPP, and we plan to conduct some in-depth support activity. We focus on analyzing and evaluation of the impact of IP issue in each field of SMEs. We may increase the number and quality of the lectures on IP training, and we strengthen international cooperation, developing and implementing IP training and consultation program and working plan. In order to further improve IP consultation and training, we look forward to learn experience from you. We know that EU IPO is very active in IP training. Your training costs are very diverse and with high efficiency. In the process of developing online training course now, we also refer a lot of experience from EU IPO training website, and we learned a lot. That's some of some information I want to share with you about IP training and supporting activity. And thank you for your attention.
Hi, everybody. My topic is the last. So I would like to introduce the topic related to strengthening the cooperation between governmental agencies and judicial authorities in IPR's enforcement in Vietnam. My content divided into three parts. The first one is intellectual property of Vietnam. The second one, I will talk about the National Steering Committee, and the last one, the new implementation plan. Now we move to the first one. I want to introduce something about my office. You can see in the slide all the activities conducted by the IP system in Vietnam. IP Vietnam is the administrative office. We are not directly involved in enforcement, but we act as the supporting organization. We give expertise opinions enforcement authority. The enforcement system include the economic police, the science technology inspector, the custom, the market surveillance, and the cost. Our mission and activity is with a leading role in IP system. We support activities of creation and utilization of intellectual property in order to contribute to the socio-economic development throughout the country. Our activity related to IP enforcement is provide expertise, opinions, and assist enforcement agencies in identifying infringement of IPR. Expert advice primarily related to the clarification of the legal status and the scope of protection of IPRs related to enforcement activities. Agency often request their expert advice include economic policy, market surveillance, competition administration department, etc. For the first 8 months of 2020, IP Vietnam has provided more than 100 expert opinions to enforcement agencies. You can see in the table. For example, you can see the majority enforcement focus on the trademark, more than 100 cases related to trademark, but only 2 cases related to patent and the truth related to designs. And among the enforcement competent authorities, we often have a cooperation with economic police and market surveillance. They often send us the request for expert opinion. Over the past years, Vietnam protection and enforcement of intellectual property rights have been constantly developing and contributing to ensuring the rights of stakeholders, promoting trade, investment, and creating fair competition. However, infringement of
IPRs has been and is getting bigger and bigger. The fight against smuggling, trade fraud, counterfeit goods, and intellectual property infringement have not been strong enough, causing concern and frustrations for the society. To solve this problem requires coordination from many sides. Therefore, on March 19, 2014, the Prime Minister decided to establish a national steering committee to combat smuggling, trade fraud, and counterfeit goods, referred to as the National Steering Committee 389, headed by Deputy Prime Minister. And members of this committee are leaders of many ministry and branches. And National Steering Committee 389 has been established since 2014. It is an agency attached to the government of Vietnam. It is organized with the task of preventing smuggling, commercial false trade, and counterfeit goods, and established under the system from the central to local. It is an interdisciplinary body consisting of the Ministry of Finance. It is a standing agency of NSC 389 at the national level. The second one is the Ministry of Industry and Trade. The third one is the Ministry of Defense and Ministry of Public Security, and also Ministry of Science and Technology. NIP Vietnam. Vietnam is organization belongs to Ministry of Science and Technology. In the first of 6 months, 2020, with the effort of determination of the NSC 389, the function force nationwide discovers and handles a total more than 70 cases, decreased 20% over the same period of 2019. It also collected and paid to the state budget more than 11 billion Vietnam dong, increased more than 80% over the same period. And it also prosecuted more than one cases, decreased 14 over the same period. Many lives and gangs were destroyed. Many conspirators and leaders were arrested and handled in accordance to the IP law and criminal law. For the Ministry of Finance, the General Department and Custom and the General Department of Taxation is the true office which is dealing with the tax under NSC 389, the General Department of Custom detected and handled 9,600 violations and paid to the state budget more than 1,000 billion Vietnam dong, prosecuted 18 cases and transferred to another agency to prosecute 32 cases, and the General Department of Taxation discovers and handles more than 20,000 violations and paid to the state budget more than 9,000 billion Vietnam dong. And for the Ministry of National Defense, the Border Guard Force and the Coast Guard have developed many plans and topics to strengthen the control of the land and sea border lines. More than 1,000 violations had been detected and handled by the border guards, and more than 160 violations have been handled by the coast guard. For the Ministry of Industrial and Trade, the market surveillance identifies the inspections and handle the hotspot on counterfeiting and infringement of IPR in the domestic market. As a region, they detected and handled more than 30,000 violations. And for the Ministry of Public Security, the police do a good basic investigation, family grabs and stated in the line area and subjects to fight the fraud, destroy lines, gangs, smuggling places, trade fraud, and counterfeiting. As a region, more than 9,000 violations was detected and handled. More than 700 cases was prosecuted, and now we move to our new implementation plan for upcoming period to solve the problem related to IPR enforcement, IPR infringement of the program on action plans against infringement of intellectual property rights phase 3 from 2019 to 2023 has been issued on 9 ministries and agencies are covered in these action plans. You can see the Ministry of Science and Technology, Ministry of Culture, Sports and Tourism, Ministry of Agriculture, Industry and Rural Development, Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Public Security, Ministry of Information and Communication, the Supreme People's Court, and Supreme People's Procuracy, all together to work the Deputy Nekpesh, the Deputy Prime Minister, the head of Chunghua Bing, the head of steering committee of NSC 389 size and issues this plan to strengthen the fight against smuggling commercial post and focused in e-commerce activities. The plan duration is from 1st November 2020 to 31st October 2022, which focused on the following tasks and solution. The first one is the strengthen inspection and supervision of the observation of law by trader, organization, and individual participating in e-commerce activity. The next is strengthen to review, amend, supplement, or promulgate new legal documents to overcome shortcomings and loopholes in order to perfect mechanisms and policies to adapt to international law and practice on e-commerce. And it focused on researching and investing information technology facility and equipment, training to improve professional qualification, improve effectiveness of the fight, prevent and fight against subjects using high technology to commit law violation in e-commerce activity. We also strengthen international cooperation with relevant organizations to coordinate investigation and handling the domain names, websites, social networks, and objects in foreign countries and users in aerial services, cyber networks provided by foreign country across borders for e-commerce activity to violate the law of Vietnam. In order to implementing the plan, the NSC 389 assigns specific tasks to each ministry. The Ministry of Industry and Trade will preside over and coordinated with the Ministry of Information and Communication, the Ministry of Public Security, and the Ministry of Justice and Ministry branches, localities, and relevant authorities to develop plans and programs to propagate and disseminate the law on e-commerce, on the violations in e-commerce activity, undetected and handled case to raise the awareness and awareness of the law observation of organizations and individuals. The Ministry of Public Security shall direct unit under the ministry and local police force to coordinate with other functional force to actively grasp the situation, collect information and document, actively detect and verify to do so, clear the violations of organizations and individuals. And the last ministry, Ministry of Finance, directs the General Department of Customs to take measures to detect and promptly prevent, investigate, and handle smuggling, commercial fraud, and counterfeit goods in e-commerce activity. The General Department of Taxation to coordinate with functional forces, telecommunication companies operating in the fields of international technology, transmission, network infrastructure, to fully update information of the organization and individual engaged in the e-commerce activity. And for our ministry, the Ministry of Science Technologies, we have instructed its subordinate units to coordinate with other functional forces to review the provision of law, promptly detect inadequacies, loophole, and overlaps in order to reach consensus proposed competent agency to amend, supplement, or issue of information and communication. State Bank of Vietnam, Vietnam e-commerce new legal documents to manage e-commerce activity. Along with that, assigning tasks to ministry and agencies, it will be Ministry of Information and Communications, State Bank of Vietnam, Vietnam E-commerce Association, Vietnam Consumer Protection Association, and so on. So it is all the thing I want to share about the activity, the plan we will do to strengthen the cooperation between the competent agencies in IPR enforcement in Vietnam. Thank you for paying attention.